Hello, this is Ron Bridges. Today we want to show you how to calibrate or do a basic calibration on an SE715 with a Stratos Evo. This will be a calibration for a amperometric Clark cell sensor where it's going to be in an immersion style application or a pipe that is ambient pressure. So right now we're reading in concentration right now, and what we want to do is go ahead and start the calibration. Before you do that though, just like in previous videos, you want to take the calibration beaker, fill a little bit of water in the bottom, then install the DO probe, but don't immerse it in the liquid and leave it there for a little while, say 15-30 minutes, and then what will happen is you'll create a 100% humidity environment, and I'll explain why that's beneficial. Secondarily, also remember you need to have the electrode connected to a power source for at least 6 hours so that the DO probe is stabilized and it's polarized. So typically we recommend if you're going to do PMs or calibrations, connect it to a power source, whether it be in this case a Stratos Evo, a Portavo, and let it power up overnight. Leave it connected so the next morning when you come in, you're ready to do a calibration. This ensures that when you take it out and swap it with the unit in the field, when you connect it to the other transmitter, you don't get sensor drift because it was not polarized. So that's why we want to have it powered overnight. So to calibrate, hit menu to cal, and we're going to do a calibration in air. Okay, so air calibration, you hit enter. The next thing it's asking is the relative humidity. Now again, as I said, because we're in this little calibration beaker, we are at 100% humidity. So I'm gonna go ahead and say enter. And here it's asking what is the air pressure. Now there's no air pressure device on the transmitter, so you have to understand or know what the current air pressure is. Right now, it is 998 millibar. Okay, and I got that off my cell phone weather app. I hit enter and it immediately starts the calibration. So the calibration time, the drift is going to be, or stabilization time is going to be anywhere from 30 to a little over 60 seconds. Once we have gotten the calibration information, we're going to take the sensor, or actually theoretically you would take the sensor, disconnect it from say this transmitter, plug it into a Portavo so that you maintain polarization, then take the sensor you just calibrated with the Portavo into the field and do your hot swap. Again, you want to make sure that if you do disconnect it from a power source after calibration, it's not disconnected for more than 5 minutes. If it is disconnected for more than 5 minutes, there's a little sheet in the box that the SE715 came in that'll tell you how long you should repolarize it to make sure or ensure you don't have any drift when you put it onto the application. So we should be close to getting calibration results. We have our zero, smiley. We are looking good. We hit enter, measure. We now have a calibrated SE715 dissolved oxygen electrode. Hopefully this is good information, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video. Thank you.